Oh, this is called Stonewall Forever, a documentary about the past, present, and future of Pride. You said you still can't believe they were so homophobes and transphobes in the comments on our last Pride video. Listen, I don't know what to say. You said me, BTS, and Stray Kids are your happy place. Thank you. You just slid me in there. I appreciate it. Thank you. Oh my God, don't make me cry. We about to watch a documentary. This is about to be. This probably will be sad. This is probably y'all. All right, y'all. This is a documentary of the past, present, and future of Pride. So I'm about to learn some things. I hope y'all learn some things too. I'm gonna record this. I don't know if this is going on YouTube. It might as well, but yeah. Let's go. I want to learn about this too. Stonewall Forever. Let's go.
We are here. We exist. We have always existed. We're gonna fucking continue to exist. I'm proud of my experience as a Black Afro-Latino transsexual male.
We should not be burdened having to pretend this is any other day. Regardless of age, sexuality, gender, or race, everyone should be standing with us. Trans rights are human rights.
Yeah.
That rally, that was put together in like 5 hours. When I got to the protest, and I saw all those people, like,
You said we don't say transsexual anymore. Transgender is the correct term. Yeah, I know. I thought that, I thought the first word was derogatory. I don't know. I'm trying to learn on the fly.
So I was at a loss for words because there was just so much power. There was so much passion. I felt like they had my back. I wouldn't be here as I am right now if it weren't for everyone who fought in the past. I only first heard about Stonewall 2 years ago. 2 years ago. Which makes me so angry because this should be taught.
The first gay riot?
I don't know when I first heard about Stonewall, but I think I always kind of heard about it in conjunction with Pride. Pride isn't just about parade that I...
Oh my God. I didn't know that this was a thing. Yo, I'm... Okay, let me not try to sound like an anarchist, but listen. Don't tell nobody, but I'm definitely for rioting if shit is not going the way it should. I'm gonna be honest. I like seeing chaos because chaos is what's gonna change stuff. So, you said Marsha P. Johnson? The trans woman who fought for the rights. Okay.
I grew up going to as a younger person.
Oh, she was the head of Stonewall.
Actually about a riot against the police.
So it was almost 50 years ago. And it's amazing how the LGBT community started fighting back against oppression and transphobia.
Okay, stand there, James.
Because of my privilege today, it's my job to educate myself on the things that they did to make this possible. You owe it to them to do that. And it's part of what you have to do as a queer person today.
Nah, this shit makes me happy, son. I did not know that, this makes me happy. I don't want to sound terrible, but I love riots, bro. Shit needs to change. Shit needs to fucking change. Last lady was Marsha. Okay.
Smells good. We're gonna stop at these benches over here. Oh. This was my bed.
Go back 2 photos. Ooh, okay. Let me go back 2 photos just to make sure I wasn't tripping. 2 photos. Oh, this is Marsha? Is this Marsha? I'm waiting on an answer. That's her. Okay, huh. All right,
and it's part of what you have to do as a queer person today.
Just so y'all know, I'm learning, so if I sound stupid, please forgive me. Stonewall.
Smells good. We're gonna stop at these benches over here. This was my bed.
Oh my.
This is my living room. So this is where I came when I was 13 years old. It was 1962, 63, you know? And when I first hit here, I was so fucking scared. This was Gay Alley. We were all out here, all kids. It would range from like 20 to maybe 30, 40, 50 lesbian and gay boys out here, drag queens, transsexuals. I definitely felt like I had a family, which I never felt before. The park was safe. The cops didn't come in and bother us that much. Stepping outside the park was a big fucking difference.
Oh my God.
Pre-Stonewall was cops. Cops, cops, cops. You always had to be watching your back.
It was just random. It was whoever's face they didn't like. There was this kind of rite of humiliation. They would have to fully humiliate you before they could let you come.
Bro.
Sexual deviancy was the main charge. But they'd tell us it was, we didn't have the three articles of female clothing on. Bra, panties, what the fuck was the other third piece, and how did they know I didn't have that on?
The accumulation of Stonewall was many years of seeing the police just barge in places.
Technically, they could arrest you for exhibiting homosexual behavior in public. And dancing with a person of the same sex, especially a slow dance, would fit the bill.
Bro, what the fuck?
We were not a protected class.
It didn't matter how many times they beat us up. Didn't matter how many times we'd go to jail. Get out of the hospital, get out of jail, and come right back to the same place again, because that was ours.
Bro, I can... What the fuck? God damn, nigga. I can... Okay, let me not go to this picture. Hold on. All right, this is a picture. This is a long-ass picture. Let me go on. Hold on. Let me. Yo, what the fuck? Like, so pretty much they could just do. Well, obviously I know that they could do whatever they wanted to. You know what I'm saying? Like the cops can do that, but it's like nigga, like niggas just create a warrant to start arresting people because they're dancing with the same sex person. That's fucking crazy, dog. Like what the fuck? That's crazy, fool. They can arrest you for anything. That's fucked up. And bro, and imagine like, and this was in the 60s, right? I don't really have knowledge of like photographic knowledge of what happened to like black folks in the 60s. But like, bruh, if you was black and queer, oh my God. Oh my fucking goodness. Bro, that's so fucked up, son. Oh my God. What the shit? I was at Square. Yeah, I was on Square. What the shit, my nigga?
It was really tough being a street queen on 42nd Street. But in the village, you thought, oh, it's okay. We could.
This shit, you saying this is long ago. This wasn't even that long ago. The people who were in it, the people who was experiencing this stuff is still alive. This wasn't that long ago.
Could hang out, not be bothered. I felt comfortable in little, sort of dirty little places.
Okay, Anaya.
You'd walk up Christopher Street, you knew everything.
You said also that, I don't know if I can say that on YouTube, pink triangles were put on queer people, and if they had the triangle, they were put back. What the shit? What the fuck?
Every fucking buddy. It was a lively neighborhood, you know, the West Village was like... gay, you know, I'm gonna use those words because queer was a bad word back then. It was gay. She wants to know
how. I said, oh wow, this is heaven. There's other people like me. There was a lot of transsexuals in this area. Tourists would come down in their double-decker buses taking pictures.
You say y'all, y'all weren't taught about
it. Outrageously.
That is that, yo, that is, oh, that is true. Hey, hey, come here. Hey, Tin, come here. That is true. To think about it, I don't think I grew up reading about or learning about like queer stuff. Huh.
And we walked up and down Christopher Street and we weren't afraid because we were in numbers. I started to grow here because I was free.
Hey, hey. Like, yeah, I never heard about this Stonewall thing. So it was like, wow.
Any other way. My best friend called me and told me, I found a gay bar and they allow you to dance with men. People haven't told me. That was the Stonewall.
Hey.
Stonewall was, you know, it was always dark in there. You had to feel your way around sometimes.
The interior of the bar was horrific. I mean, they didn't have running water.
Oh, jeez.
So no one ordered, if you knew, no one ordered a drink in a glass. But it was ours, I mean. So who cared what it looked like?
Oh.
And it was always crowded, you know, always crowded. Like, you'd see queer people outside, but walking into the bars and seeing so many of us, you know, it was like, yeah, you know, like, was home.
All places that were frequented by gay people were much more diverse. There weren't many bars, and we were all under siege.
You said RuPaul always talks about Stonewall? Really? Huh. I don't really, no, the last thing I seen about RuPaul was the house tour. I think I seen a house tour, but yeah, I think that's what it is. I'm not tapped in. Oh my god.
My first lover.
You said read yours. You said, oh, and trans rights are currently being taken away. That's what I'm saying, like, bro, this is obviously not that long ago. If shit like this is still flying. Like, shit like this is still flying, bro. Like, this shit is crazy as hell.
We had just come back in from Washington. We were passing forged checks and whatnot, but we were making good money.
Yeah.
And so, well, let's go to Stonewall.
Oh, God, Blue Dream.
The police came in. They came in to get their pay off, as usual.
You said read yours, too? I got you. Hold on. He says, we still have so much farther to go. Just Saturday, you went to a pride parade in Ocean City over the weekend. You from Maryland? Over the weekend, and you got yelled at and called slur and was chased. What the fuck? You and your friends were running, and y'all got pepper sprayed. Yo, what the fuck? In Ocean City? What the shit? What the shit? Yo, that's not cool, cuz. All right, Sally. You said, people of color, queer people fought in the front lines, yet we only see white queer rights being the most accepted. I don't even want to go into that. I don't even want to go into that, man. Hey. Yeah, I don't even want to go into that. Let's keep going.
This is what we learned to live with at that time.
Oh, New Jersey.
I don't know if it was the customers or was the police. It just, everything clicked.
1969.
It was a crowded Friday night. But someone.
Yeah, I know. I know, Jackson. I'm aware. Oh, what does it say at the bottom? It says, at the bottom, it says, because of the lack of images of many of the events discussed, the images used in this documentary are taken from a number of events that took place during the 50s, 60s, and 70s.
At Queens Island.
Okay.
People were dragged.
Good night.
From
Have
the
fun
bar
in school.
And were shoved into the paddy wagon.
They were pushing this queen into a paddy wagon, and I saw her heel come out and hit the cop's shoulder and push him back. He jumped in, and you could hear bone against metal.
Bruh, what the fuck?
And he said, all right, you fags, you saw what you wanted the show's off, now get the fuck out of here. We went for him. And there was enough provocation in every section, the riot was on.
Yes, riot this motherfucker.
The police were there in massive numbers, because that's one of the first time a gay, lesbian, bisexual, transgender group had ever fought back. But you can only take so much shit.
Exactly.
Do you know what I mean?
Exactly. Fight back. Fuck. Mm-hmm.
The word started coming down into the park that there was this altercation over near Stonewall.
Jackson, that shit is fucked up. They really trying their hardest to try to, like, you know, try to get people still scared of, like, queer people. It's weird. It's fucking weird. They've been doing this shit for a long time, son. Like, that shit is weird, bro.
We got up here, it was like hundreds of people already. There was trans women, there were lesbians, there were femmes, there were drag queens, there was white, there was black, there was Asian. Everybody was fucking out here.
Oh yeah, that is true. Oh yeah. Hey, this is something. Hey, listen. I might get called a word for this, but hey, just so y'all know, being a part of the community, this is not for me, a cis man. This is from Jackson. So I'm just relaying the message. Just because you are a part of the community, that don't mean you got an excuse to be a bad person or a bigot. So listen, yo. Hey, don't use that as an excuse, bro.
Liberation. You know, we felt empowered, like, you know, this is who we are. We're not going any fucking where.
And it just took him a minute.
And also, having that as an excuse is not, bro, having that as an excuse is not helping. In my opinion, it's not helping. It's actually making things worse because the people who are trying to get, like, the people who are trying to put a bad light on the community, they're going to use the bigotry as a way to, you know, keep them in the dark. Like, it's just...
...of its own. There was no leaders. Nothing was planned. But everything went amazingly in our favor.
Because y'all doing the right thing, that's why.
About 3-4 o'clock in the morning, they finally got the streets cleared. We went back to the park, and we talked about it all fucking night. Had no idea that it was going to blow up into, you know, gay pride.
Queen bees are stinging. Oh, that's a... Queen bees are stinging. That's fire.
Disturbances around the stone wall lasted for about 3 or 4 days. I wish I could say that I had a crystal ball and I thought this was going to be the beginning of social change, but I didn't see much happening.
I'd be seeing that too, Jackson.
What made the Stonewall Uprising really different was that 2 weeks later, the Gay Liberation Front sent out a notice that they were organizing.
1969.
We don't care if straight people accept us. We're going to be who we are. And if you don't like who we are, just get out of our way.
Yeah, just mind your fucking business. If you don't fuck with this, mind your business, bro.
We came up with the idea of a pride march. We called it the Christopher Street Liberation Day March.
Christopher Street Liberation Day March. Oh. You said there's a Republican senator trying to pass a law making it legal for a teacher to check children's... Excuse me? Huh? What? So somebody's trying to make it legal to do something illegal. What? This shit gonna give me a headache, bro. I understand it's because of the laws against trans people, but still, that's you shouldn't. What the fuck? Oh my god! What the fuck? God damn it. God damn it. You say you happy you're living in the U.S.? A moon.
We envisioned that people would march out of the village to the daylight of Central Park, where we would have a big party, we would have political speeches, and we would be free.
That shit is fucked up, Blue.
Because you see, this march was very, daring. Because
hold on, wait, god damn it. Whoa, hold on. Isn't one of the reasons why people are against, like, the community and what's going on is because they want to protect the children? Isn't that one of the reasons why they're doing all this? That doesn't really seem very protecting. All right. Okay. What the fuck? Ugh. You said you have something you want me to read at the end? Okay. That's so backwards. That's so fucking backwards. That's back. Hey, Slim, I swear to hey, I'm gonna be honest. Hey, if they still doing this shit when I have a family, if y'all see me on the news going to school, knocking some teachers out, just turn a blind eye, okay? Because you're not finna be checking my child's private areas to see if they what the fuck. Get the fuck out of here, my nigga. No, I don't give a fuck about what law says you can do that. You're not finna do that to my child. I don't give a fuck. Nigga.
In an age of violence, Kent State, the assassinations in the United States, and so this was not an easy time to form a gay march.
1970.
We had to go single file so that we could elongate ourselves and look like this was a march. But what happened was, as we kept going,
they don't be trying to protect the kids
from the sidelines, from the streets, the people would join
us. Not protecting these
children. And he didn't notice
right
away, but it was growing. What began as a question mark downtown ended in an exclamation point. The march made us public, and we all knew it was different now, and we were going to live differently. We started to become a people.
Whether you came in today to come out.
That's what I'm saying, bro. What the fuck, bro? Like, this shit is...
Waking up to say, hip, hip, hooray, I'm glad I'm gay.
You tell me, Jackson, that shit is so ass backwards, bro. Like, people were literally going to school shooting children. But just... Oh my god, this shit gonna give me a headache.
Can't repress my happiness,
Nate Barker.
Ever since I tried your way.
You said it's just so disappointing and disgusting to see that other human beings are so uncomfortable with the fact that another human being is different than them. Both are humans, but some people just can't stand to see others happy and be treated like humans just because they love someone they would not, or it is not what they consider traditional normal love. Bro, I don't understand why people can't just mind their own fucking business. Like, bro, what the fuck?
Gonna lay right here and greet the sun. Cause gay time,
bro, it's not like they hurt people, though. You know what I'm saying?
Come on, let's jump.
See, that's probably why. Bro, that's probably why. That's probably why they think it's like, they think y'all are easy target. That's probably why. This is why I'm for, like, the fighting back. Because if y'all start, you know what I'm saying, if niggas start going crazy, then they gonna be like, oh, all right, yeah, they not playing. Can we actually, let's actually, like, treat them like human. Like, it's sad that it has to get to that point, but shit, right. Burn all this shit down. Burn all this shit the fuck down. I hope you have fun, Ray.
My expectation, and that of many people of color in that moment, was that this movement would also understand that there had to be a commitment to issues beyond the ones that were clearly on the table.
Mm-hmm.
We are everywhere in terms of, we are every permutation of humanity in terms of identities, you know, from race and class and gender.
How your back
what
clear?
Movement. To set as its vision and mission a connectedness with all of the struggles for justice.
I like that sweater. That's a nice ass sweater. That's a
the
really
work
nice
was
ass
cut
sweater.
Out for us, for sure.
Let her speak. Just a moment. Just a moment.
Just Christopher
a
Street Liberation Day.
I would like
day
to avoid any trouble. This is a day of unity for us. I want us to be happy.
Fights to make her way on stage after multiple attempts to block her from speaking. Bro, I don't even know what to say to this. I just want to sit. I'm just gonna just sit and learn, but because I don't have like, you know what I'm saying. I don't got the, I guess, the audacity to speak on it. But that's interesting. That's very, very interesting.
Y'all better quiet down. I've been trying to get up here all day for your gay brothers and your gay sisters in jail. They write me every motherfucking week, and you all don't do a goddamn thing for them. Mm. I have been beaten. I have had my nose broken. I have been thrown in jail. I have lost my job. I have lost my apartment for gay liberation. And you all treat me this way? What the fuck's wrong with you all?
I could not believe it was like a nightmare. All these white men and women were booing her.
The people that are trying to do something for all of us, and not men and women that belong to a white middle class, white club. And that's what y'all belong to. Revolution now!
I fucks with this, guy. I really fucks
Sylvia
with this.
And Marsha, they led the fight for transgender rights.
Okay.
Because in the earlier days, the lesbians and the gays, they never included transgender people. And when we say equality, equality has to be for everybody.
I could not believe that all of us who were at those protests were ignored. We really didn't exist. We were a nuisance, an embarrassment.
I have a question. So what is that about? See, I want to like actually have a conversation with someone who's like, I guess back, who's like in that back then, who could probably make some sense out of this, because I don't understand why is this inner disagreement? Like, I don't understand it. Like, why it boggles my fucking mind, bro.
Marsha P. Johnson and Sylvia Ray Rivera planted the seeds that took so long to grow and take root. They were there in the front lines. And it was just so
it still is a disagreement.
There were people who stood back, like embarrassed. We are not one of you.
I was almost always in a state of dissonance working in the LGBT movement, even as I worked for lesbian and gay rights, that there was not a general understanding that our struggle needed to be much broader.
You said they accused trans of trying to steal women's culture. How are y'all not a part of the community and it's in the name? Ain't that what the T is in LGBTQ? Plus, what the fuck is going on, man?
You rolled up your sleeve and you're like, how the hell do we get these people to understand that you've got to see these connections?
Bro, my mirror just fell. Give me a second. Holy fuck.
What the hell? Why did you fall? How did this even happen? Bruh, heavy ass mirror. No, it came on the wall. What the fuck? No. I'll worry about this later. I'll worry about that later.
Okay, let's keep going. You said you hate the phrase trans women are taking up women's spaces. I just
experience as a woman, my experience as a lesbian, my experience as a black person become equally important in terms of how we do this work to dismantle the whole house, to bring it all down. The commitment to seeing the linkages of liberation as one, it wouldn't.
You said saying just trans, atrans, transgenders, etc., is dehumanizing. Is that because it's like taking away like the trans man or trans woman part, and it's just like, is that like, what's the word? I don't know. Let's just go with dehumanizing.
Not be one for a very, very long time. I don't think I ever had a timeline.
But the work that's being done now
is like, yes! It's like, you know, you won't even see the shit coming.
Oh, objectification. Okay.
Generations to live with this indignity. We have a duty to action today. People showed up. Mm-hmm. People showed out.
We will be erased!
Part of it is that they can't envision us living with a non-binary body in a binary world. And you know what? That's on all of us to change. If we didn't fight back, then what are we gonna say in the future? How are we gonna write our stories? How are people gonna read our stories?
I think it's so important to preserve queer history that includes trans people and intersex people and gender non-conforming people. Because I think for me as a young person, being able to see those images of like, oh, these people look like me. I can see myself in history. I can see myself as part of a longer legacy.
I feel like I'm still fighting for everything that they were fighting for back then, because sadly, yes, things have improved, but it's not like we are there yet.
60% of the trans community doesn't have an employment.
God damn.
We don't have access to housing. We have documents to live in this country.
60%?
There is a lot of hate crimes.
Cause 60%? Yo, what the fuck? That, god damn.
I want my community to feel safe. And that's the reason why I do this type of work.
I hope that...
You said, to trans people, it's like the same feeling when people call black people a black or blacks. Oh, okay. I see what you mean. I see what you mean now. Okay.
People who need platforms and need to tell their story are given exactly that.
Hi, my name is Chella Mann, and this is my voice one day on T. And this is my voice 3 weeks on T.
It's 12 weeks on T. It's 26 weeks on T. Okay. 1 year on T.
Just there's so many different ways you can approach your identity.
56%.
And I feel like that is also contributing to why there's another queer movement on the horizon.
Hey, don't make me close the door. Why you keep stop barking at the window, man? 50 cents per six. God, bro. Oh my God.
I believe that queer and trans people were a manifestation of the future. I would love to see a future where all of the restrictive social structures that we see so clearly and have words for, words like white supremacy, patriarchy, colonialism, sexism, where those things have been obliterated.
People that are gonna come in the future are gonna need our words and need our experiences. Just like we needed those words and experiences and truths from those who came before us.
I am fighting to hold on to the gains that we've made. The vision of the Gay Liberation Front, that people have the right to civil rights, to health care, to not be attacked.
We're fighting now for acceptance in schools. In Las Vegas, we just won a battle to let transgender people go to school as trans.
I'm still passionate about homelessness in our community. Yeah, I'm so fucking passionate about that.
I am for all the young voices who are against guns and for education, for housing.
This battle has become global, and I'm in awe of the people today have kept the battle up.
While we're here, we do all that we can to make our mark, that we were here and that we mattered, so that someone in the future can know that they mattered too.
Hey Jackson, I just want to let you know, well for me, it's not that bad. It's not like you said nigga, so don't feel too dirty. Don't feel too dirty. Stonewall Forever. This was good. I learned a lot. Wow. Wow. Yo, shout out to y'all. God damn. This was fire. This was fire. I like this. I'm still happy that what's it called? I'm gonna let this ride out. Hey, Google supported it. Hey, shout out to Google, I guess. Yo, this was, I like this. I learned stuff. You said this is one of the reasons why I really wanted to do this stream. Good. Thank you. I respect this because, like, I didn't, like, it's weird that, like, there's still, like, disagreements inside this community. It's like, why aren't y'all fighting for the same shit? Don't y'all think trapping backwards like that and excluding people? Don't y'all think excluding people in a movement to be included is the best thing to it? That's the best way to go if you're trying to get a good outcome. Like, I don't know. Like I said, I'm here to observe and learn because I am learning off the fly. You know what I'm saying? And now that I know that they was rioting this shit, stop it. Now that I know that they was rioting, I love it. Burn this shit to the ground. Burn all this shit to the motherfucking ground because shit needs to change. You said stop barking. All right, I'm closing the door.
You've lost your door privileges, buddy. Nope. You lost all your door privileges. I gotta read a message and you over here barking and shit.
All right, so you said read Brooke's message. Where is it? Why are you still barking, nigga? I can't find it. Oh, you said, I'm not sure if everyone in chat knows this, but the Human Rights Campaign has declared a state of emergency for the... All? A state of emergency for the LGBTQ plus people in the U.S.? What the fuck? Bro, I didn't even know it got that bad, bro. Like, this shit is insane. 10, stop it. Go sit down. This is crazy. You said you'll find it and show me? Please. What in the fuck? You said at the end of the day, why we set boundaries around everything and every people because they chose to be themselves. Like, people be having the most energy for something that don't need to have that much energy for. Like, people really just want to be themselves and everybody's got a fucking problem with it. Like, I don't get it, bro. I really don't get it. I don't know. Thank you. Let's see this thing. Say Uganda has made it illegal to be. God. Okay. All right. So it says, for the first time ever, we're declaring a national state of emergency as LGBTQ plus Americans face extremist attempts to roll back our rights. It's more important than ever we have the necessary resources to stay safe no matter where we are. Hey, man. In all honesty, all right, Mercy. Bye. Much love to you as well. Hope you have a good rest of your day. In all honesty, I hope they start burning this shit to the ground. Like really, because this is. Nah. Oh my god, bro, this shit is getting bad. This is for burning what? Burning buildings? Riot? Fucking riot! They need to burn all this. They need to show people that they not plant. Like, bro, this shit is weird. I'm talking about, like, the community when it comes to getting the equality they want. Like, it might be time to riot again, bro. I'm gonna be honest, but I'm not the person to say it. But just so y'all know, y'all have my respect. Shit needs to be done. It really does need to be done because this shit is crazy. So this has been building up for years. Said you about to start a riot and nothing changes. Hey, make sure you do, like, make sure you have, like, riot etiquette. Because you don't want to, you know what I'm saying? You don't want to get yourself hurt. You know what I'm saying? I don't want y'all to get hurt. Like, safely riot. If that makes sense. I don't know. I hope that makes sense. I don't know.